And we are back for part three of 6 feet apart, but not really 6 feet apart because I just love her and I don't want to be apart. And we're with Jennifer baking our pie. What has happened now?
Talk to us. So we have cooked the cherry filling. Mm-hmm. See now it's coating the spoon. So it's started to thicken up and it's a dark red. This juice is a dark red color now.
Okay.
All right, so now I'm gonna add a little almond extract.
Okay.
This happens to be my favorite.
Okay.
It's a quarter of a teaspoon.
Mm-hmm.
If you don't like almond, that's okay. Don't add it.
Could you use vanilla?
You could use vanilla. You could use a little lemon.
Ooh.
Cherries and almond are kind of a traditional match. But there's no need to be traditional if you don't want to be.
You could probably even do like a sprinkle of cinnamon at the end, right?
You could definitely. And there's definitely recipes out there that have cinnamon and different spices like that in their cherry pies. So you play around with it.
Yes.
Okay, so our pie dough is ready to be rolled out.
Okay.
So we're gonna sprinkle.
And again, I don't know if you guys caught that, if you're skipping around videos, Jennifer mentioned you want a nice, cool, she uses marble at home. This is a copper countertop, so it stays nice and cool, and we did clean it thoroughly right before she did this, FYI.
Yes. Yeah, nobody wants breadcrumbs in their pie.
No, no. If you want breadcrumbs, you can buy her bread.
That's right.
So this is half of it.
This is half the recipe. So this is going to be the bottom. And you want to make sure you move your pie dough around while you're rolling it. So always keep it moving. If it starts to stick, you just get it in that flour. So when you look at it, you can see little bits of butter.
Mm-hmm.
That is going to make your pie crust flaky. Light and flaky, which is why you don't want to over mix it in your mixer.
I'm really curious to see how many customers replicate this. Send a picture, email it to info@brickandbarn.com. We would love to post it and share how you guys are little Betty Crockers of your own.
I would love that.
Wouldn't that be great?
Because the thing I love about baking is baking for other people.
Mm-hmm.
And especially during this time, it's just so nice to have something that is full of love and fresh and not from a market where there's a lot of chaos and fear.
Yes.
So
something big just happened there. Can you tell us what you did?
Okay. So, I'm sorry, I went fast.
That was awesome.
So, after you roll it out, and here's the top crust, so I can show you one more time.
Okay.
And
you see, you guys, there is an overlap. For some of us that don't make pie crusts, that is nice.
Yeah, you want it to be a little bit bigger so that your edges seal.
Oops.
Because you don't really want pie filling on the bottom of your oven. So if your pie crust is sealed around the edges really well, then your oven should stay relatively clean.
So Jennifer, you guys, has been baking for as long as I've known her. And as she mentioned, it was your grandmother, right, who got you into baking?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, she and I used to make bread and cookies, and just she loved to bake.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I'm gonna do it one more time.
Okay, I'm ready for you.
Okay, so I'm gonna put the rolling pin at one end and roll it over, and then I'm just gonna keep rolling it. And then when I put it down, I'm gonna put it down on the other edge, and I'm just gonna unroll it onto the pie. And that way I end up getting it nice and even. So I'm gonna need to trim this. I put my little knife over here, so I'm just trim around the edges and leave a little edge so that, like I said, you can make a nice seal.
And by the way, you guys, if you follow us on Instagram or Facebook, the Brick and Barn channels, and you want to know a little bit more about Jennifer on a personal note, we did a profile on her and kind of told her story and how she has blessed me personally for years with food. So when I am sick, if I even ask for it or not, I will get chicken soup, homemade, and fresh bread at my door. And of course, she always keeps our bellies happy with fresh baked goods. And yeah, blessing through food.
Yes. Okay, here's our vintage pot of cherries.
Ooh, beautiful.
So we're gonna go ahead and put this in our pan. It's okay if it's hot. You can go ahead and put it right in because our oven is hot, and there'll be plenty of time for it to get all cooked down and be good.
So this is the full two cans is what you would
this
say
is,
put in there.
Yeah, okay. This is two cans of those cherries. Okay. And that's gonna be, you know, most of the pies weigh about 2 pounds when they're done. So it's about 2 pounds of fruit.
Okay. Okay. Is there a benefit of, I mean, could you technically make more filling and freeze it or refrigerate it, or is that a no-no?
You can freeze this filling. It freezes and defrosts really easily.
Okay.
So you could refrigerate it for, I don't know, probably it'll be fine for a week.
Okay.
Not in the pie crust though. Can't freeze it. You could freeze it in an uncooked pie crust. But don't refrigerate it in an uncooked pie crust because the crust will get soggy.
Okay.
But if you froze it right away, it would be okay.
Okay.
Although I don't think the crust will turn out as flaky, mm-hmm. but you could still get away with it because mm-hmm. who's going to complain about a homemade cherry pie?
Not I.
No.
Not I. Great juice.
This is quiet.
Okay.
So here's an important thing about the pie crust, and I want to show you. Here's the bottom crust, and here's my top crust.
Okay.
I'm gonna fold them over each other, and I'm sealing that bottom crust with the top crust, and I'm gonna do that quickly all the way around.
This is amazing. I'm so mesmerized. Honestly.
So, and remember, it's homemade, so it's supposed to look homemade. And if your fingers stick to the crust, just flour them. And then you're just gonna go around and crimp your edges.
She was a crimp slowly.
Okay,
crimp.
So two, a thumb and a forefinger and another finger. And you're just gonna push it into those two fingers to make that little crimp.
Nice. And if you wanted to personalize your pie even more, you could do a little cutout, right? Of like a something seasonal, like a leaf if it's fall, with a pumpkin pie.
Because
or...
you always have a little extra dough, and so you could roll this out and use a cookie cutter and cut something and put it on the top. The other thing is you always want to leave a little vent on the top so that the steam can come out so your pie doesn't explode out the edges.
Okay,
so here's the finishing touch. And don't ever forget, because it makes your pie pretty.
Yes.
Okay, one fresh egg from Brick and Barnes Chickens.
So I want you guys to see the color of this yolk right here, because we are going to start selling our eggs at Brick and Barn.
So.
Look at how bright that is.
Look at that pretty egg yolk. Beautiful.
This guy's really excited because he gets eggs every day.
So, if you have a pastry brush, that's great.
And we do.
Marlise, do you have a pastry brush?
I do. Where's my set team? Props, right. Props. How's
it? Perfect.
Good?
This is a good one.
Okay.
This is the one I have at home.
Nice.
Okay, so we're just gonna brush the top of the pie.
Okay.
And this is gonna make it bake up nice and shiny. And it looks so pretty. It looks all golden, like it looks in the magazines. And then I'm gonna sprinkle it with a little bit of sugar. And then it goes into a 400 degree oven for about 30 minutes.
Nice.
And that is your cherry pie.
Amazing. And you would pair it with what? An ice cream, whipped cream?
We like it with vanilla ice cream.
Mm.
Yes.
I'm so excited. Okay, don't go anywhere. you are going to get to see me eat this pie in just a moment. Stay tuned.
We're back and our pie is ready to come out of the oven.
Our timer just went off.
So it's actually been about 35 minutes. And here is what you want it to look like. A nice golden brown.
Look at that.
Now, one thing I didn't mention was I sprinkled the top after I brushed it with the egg white. I sprinkled the top with sugar. It's optional. You could also use cinnamon or something like that if you wanted. Mm-hmm. But I like the look of a little dusting of sugar on the top. Mm-hmm. And you're going to want to cool it on a wire rack.
Can you serve it hot without it cooling?
You like can. Mm. The only thing is that it's not going to cut into a magazine style slice. It is going to be squishy. Mm-hmm. But that makes it super good with ice cream because the ice cream's going to get all melty. And so.
Yeah, that's awesome.
That is.
And tell us, there was a little bit of crust left over.
Yes.
Where did that end up?
So, I don't like to waste anything.
No, nothing gets wasted.
And when you're, one of the fun things about cooking is coming up with ways to use extra stuff that you have left over. So here's a little bit of pie dough and you could roll it out in a circle like this. You could stuff it with some cheese, perhaps some fresh kale from Brick and Barn's garden.
And if you guys make this recipe and you have that left over, call us, text us, email us, and we will give you free kale or Swiss chard to make your own little pocket.
Yes. So you can make your own little hot pocket. You'll stuff it, fold it over. You use a fork or your finger and just smush all around the edge to seal it up. Put it in the oven and bake it until it's golden brown. I don't know, maybe 15 minutes. And it's a great healthy little snack for your kids.
Unless you stuff it with chocolate and banana.
Oh my goodness.
Just came up with that. Nutella.
Peanut butter and jelly. Who needs Crustables or whatever they are from Costco?
No, no.
You can make this.
You can make that. Fill it with jam.
Pan and Swiss?
Yes.
Great. And I usually do. I fill mine with jam a lot of times. And then they eat them instead of a Pop-Tart for breakfast.
Oh my goodness, so, you guys. That's so great. So for the moment you've all been waiting for, we are going to dig into this. And okay, so we are going to take this out to the kids and we are all going to take a bite of the pie and you can see what you're missing out on. And look at again at that crust, you guys. That is fabulous. I can't wait. Hang on.
So
we'll
just
went
to check on the kids and what happened?
They're skinny dipping in Marlise's pool. So that leaves more pie for us.
Yes.
So open hand.
Yes, we're very excited.
So get ready to try the pie with us.
And you guys, trust me, like, look, we're just stabbing
nice,
at it.
Yes, flaky crust.
Oh my goodness.
I never know when. Okay, here we go.
Here we go. Get some cherries.
And again, you guys, you make this for your company, you make it for your spouse. Oh my goodness, you're going to be loved forever. Here I go. I'm over my mouth. So good. Really, really good and really, really, really hot. You guys, don't forget, bread and butter, she's available. All of her baked goods are here every show. Our next show is May 15, 16, 17. We hope we're open. And if we're not, we are taking orders. Pies, breads, cookies, with a 24-hour turnaround. Don't forget, you have to place your orders by 3 p.m. the previous day. They can be waiting at the gate for you. You just have to call 760-651-2635, and this lady will get a bacon, right?
I will.
Thanks for joining us.
Thank you so much.
Okay,
take care.
Bye. Be safe.